Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. Feast your eyes on Forearm's homeworld, Koros, a savage wasteland where only the strong survive. Koros is home to the Tetramans, warriors who pride themselves on their strength. While four formidable arms are their calling card, they certainly don't skip leg day. Tetramans put their undeniable strength to the test inside massive arenas built for gladiatorial games. Female Tetramans are stronger than the males and are viewed as the superior contestants. But Tetramans are not the only tough creatures on Koros. Warriors also face off against beasts of the wild in survival challenges, and these are no ordinary creatures. They've evolved multiple limbs, just like the Tetramans, to endure on this warring world. But it's no problem for the Tetramand Overlordess. Surprise, surprise, she's crowned champion yet again. We were lucky to survive this match. Outer space sure sounds safer. Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers, to the crystalline jewel Petropia, home of Diamondhead's Petrosapien people. It's hard to imagine that something as fragile looking as crystal could be stronger than steel. The Petrosapiens crafted a kingdom of stunning proportions and breathtaking beauty on the surface. But their ancestral cousins, the Subsapiens, toiled far below ground in the planet's deep substrata. Spartan and warlike, the Subsapiens long possessed no awareness of the vast world above them. But now they stand poised to break out from under and claim it as their own. These two factions, though similar, are now pitted against each other, locked in a battle, not knowing that both are puppets, part of a larger scheme. A third faction dwelling even deeper within their world, the Antrosapiens, waiting patiently for the right moment to strike and take everything from their distant cousins. Ooh, scary stuff. But the fate of Petropia is a story for another day. For now, onward! Whew! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. Is it hot in here, or is it just a pyronite from Heat Blast's bright planet-like star, Pyros? On the world of Pyros, rivers of molten lava cut through the endless fire-singed tundra. Who could possibly want to live here? These guys. Pyronites are living, thermodynamic beings that radiate enormous amounts of heat energy. Fierce planetary conditions make it ideal for the locals to spend the days putting the extreme in the phrase extreme sports. But it's not all fun and games to the Pyronites. They're working to perfect their pyrokinetic powers. In the native ecosystem, Pyronites can channel flames in order to generate propulsion, which allows them to surf the scorching hot air. It might look like it's all too hot to handle, but if you ask them, these young Pyronites would likely say, "Hoo-hoo! What a blast!" I don't know about you, but I can't take the heat. What say we head off to colder climes? Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. Follow along, if you can keep up, because this tour of Accelerate's homeworld is going to happen lightning fast. Kinacelerans need to be quick, because their home planet, Kinet, is a swirling sphere of bellowing electrical storms. This ambitious Kinacelerin is undertaking a long-observed rite of passage, the running of the gauntlet for the rollerballs Kinacelerans wear on their feet. If you think this youngling is fast now, wait until he gets those gliders. The gliders are actually the precious pearls of a Kinet Molluscarks. But how to get them? Remember what I said about Kinacelerin lightning? Smart Kinacelerins stand back and let Mother Nature do the trick. Success! Once obtained, the gliders allow for speeds of more than 500 miles per hour and the incredible ability to run up walls. It's a win. But watch out for that Molluscarks right behind you. Don't get caught up by those lightning forks. You should make it home in time for the party. Wow, that one went by fast. Onward. Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. You'll need a brain as big as Gray Matter's to cram for this quiz about the DNA banks of his home planet, Galvan Prime. Once regarded as little more than pets, their owners eventually realized the Galvan's Omega Point superintelligence and things rapidly changed. The Galvans became the galaxy's most savvy engineers, technicians, and searchers. Nothing could quench their thirst for knowledge and their hunt to catalog all interstellar DNA. The Galvans built an armada of sentient drones. Probing the cosmos, these drones sought out alien civilizations, scientific anomalies, and singularities that only an advanced Galvan mind could comprehend. The immense troves of DNA information they collected from every alien species in the cosmos were uploaded into Galvan Prime's central computer, ensuring that Galvan Prime would forever remain the center of research into the DNA of the universe. Ugh, I don't think my brain has any more room for big words or fancy phrases. Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. Today we journey to the Andromeda Galaxy and Overflow's home planet Cascaro. The Cascan people dwell beneath the waves of their immense liquid world to avoid the perils of its dangerous surface, torrential hurricanes, and a plague of pillaging pirates. These hardened seafarers are on an endless quest for the raw material that constitutes their exoskeleton armor, serpent glass, pilfered from the deadly, dangerous, delicate spires that dot their oceanic horizon. And while it may seem that their biggest challenge is this lengthy leviathan lurking in the shadows, the true enemy is other Cascan pirates waiting to abscond with their ill-gotten gains. Their hydrokinetic abilities allow them to use water as weapons. As long as their skills are well honed, the pirate captains of Cascan will remain the masters of their ocean world. But I think it's time to make like a leviathan and blow this splashy sphere. Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. I've upgraded you to first class for our next tour, Galvan B, home of Upgrade, a galvanic mechamorph. The moon of Galvan Prime is once a barren gray globe devoid of natural life. In an attempt to terraform the moon into its own inhabitable world, the Galvans, led by a great and wise scientist, accidentally crashed with unexpected results. The first galvanic mechamorphs. They spread across the landscape like some techno-organic virus. Mechamorphs possess the ability to merge with and enhance any technology from the inside out. They used this ability to transform the surface of Galvan B, and their entire civilization sprung up practically overnight. There's a legend among Galvans that if their moon was ever destroyed, the Mechamorphs could reform it by merging all of their kind together. I don't know if that's true or not, but I do hope this brief tour of their home has been transformational. Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. I hope you like your veggies, because we're heading to Flores Verdance, homeworld of Wildvine. Flores Verdance is a green gem, with a plant-based florana are wilder than their verdant environment. While many of the inhabitants spend their days in peaceful reflection, taking in the beauty of their forests, other locals favor their wilder sides. Using their green thumbs to poke sleeping giants, they race each other to see who's got the chops to avoid getting the chumps. But this plant bites the hand that feeds, and no matter what language it's in, the phrase remains the same. You kids, stay off my lawn! They might pretend to be excited by reaching the finish line first, but you can bet it's as much a sigh of relief as a victory whoop. Never a dull moment in this jungle joyride. And the grass is always greener on the other side of Flores Verdance. Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers, to the fun and sun of Arburia, homeworld of Cannonbolt. Life may be a beach on Arburia, but that ideal tropical climate is outside, while the young Arburian Pelorotas are inside all day long. With 12-hour classes of science, math, physics, it's a lot for a young Pelorota to focus on with all that fun and sun just outside. So the second their day is done, Pelorotas are out the door, trading business and books for sea and sand. Although this spherical species is known for their ability to curl into a ball and use their bodies as tools and weapons, their spheroid physiques also make them perfect belly flop divers. Arburian Pelorotas can even dive from the stratosphere, damage-free. They don't skydive, they space dive. As fun as it looks, that doesn't mean you should join them, unless you're indestructible. Luckily, we have other planets on our horizon. Onward! Welcome, explorers and omniplanetary travelers. Plug your nose as we descend on Stinkfly's planet, Lepidoptera. Oh, the smelliest habitable planet in the Milky Way. Its advanced ecosystem allows for numerous stages of the same species to share in its symphony. Life here remains harmonious, thanks to the committed effort by each and every creature to make sure all native wildlife continues to thrive. Which sometimes means rounding up the rowdier beasts so they don't hurt the tamer ones. Spitting slime and blowing toxic gas gives the Lepidopterans more than one way to stop a charging stinkworm or two. Or three. But from the ashes of a gargantuan grub rises the light of the larval stink brood, which, upon hatching, birth more Lepidopterans into the world. The synchronized cycle of life continues, although life there is a bit smellier than most. Here's hoping our next destination smells more like a bed of roses. Onward!